We're now going to take a moment to look at the different folder and file structures that are created by the different Synapse Link configurations. So first, we'll take a moment to look at the incremental. What you'll notice is that each time a incremental export is run, it will create a new folder, and that folder has the timestamp when it was executed. This is a very easy way of managing what is the latest folders and searching for only the latest data that's being exported. Now, if we look in one of these folders, we can see that it has the tables that have been exported. And then within the table folder, it has a CSV file which contains the data that was exported. If we look at that quickly, in this CSV file, we can see that there have been 4 sales lines added during this particular iteration. And the first column, column A, represents the IDs of these 4 columns that have been exported. And this is a unique ID for this each record. And this is important, obviously, for inserts, updates, and delete capabilities. Now, if we want to look at and discuss the delete and how a delete is propagated within the incremental design, we again go into the folder structure, and we see that there is a CSV file. And if again we look at that particular CSV file,
now the first 3 fields are ID, sync created on, and sync modified on. You'll notice that the rest of the fields associated with the record are blank, including the rec ID. Thus, if you want to be able to map from ID to rec ID in order to be able to identify this record in a downstream system, you can use various tools we've made available. These are documented on GitHub. We have a Python sample code and TSQL, which can convert the ID field into the rec ID so you can map it downstream. Now, going back to the CSV file for a moment, you'll notice that at the end there is a field called, or a column called, isDelete. And this has been set to true. The mapping of these columns and is available via the model.json file.
Now let's take a moment and look at the Parquet Delta Lake format. So in the Delta Lake Parquet format file structure, we see that we have just one folder that has the date, which means that the other folders or the other exported data has already been processed. And what you'll notice is that there is a Delta Lake folder. This is where the process changes have been stored. And within the Delta Lake format, we see all of the files, all of the objects that have been exported. And then within them, we see the partitioned folders to further partition it. And within that information, you see the Parquet Delta Lake formatted files.